Welcome back once again in a new episode of Women Wellness with Blush and Curls. Today we are going to talk about a topic that you guys have requested with my continuation of my previous episodes that we have spoken about hair, which is the hair taming treatment or any kind of hair chemically treated or, you know, making straightening treatment. So what is this straightening treatment? What is a hair taming treatment? Why is it important to do this treatment? What are the things that you need to take care when you do these kind of treatments and the aftercare of these treatments? So that's what we are going to discuss today in today's episode about hair. Since it is summer and this is the highest time we see that, you know, people undergo these kind of taming treatment simply because it makes the life more easier and it makes everyone's life much comfortable, because if you have a thick and a coarse or a dense hair and if you have a frizzy hair, you really don't have to take care after you do the straightening system. It might last you for about 6 to 7 months or it can last you even about for a year. So the things that you need to take care, especially when you undergo these kind of treatments, there are wide number of treatments available in the market and you need to be careful with these kind of treatments, because if you are not careful with these treatments, it can cause you a big health hazard. Yes, you heard me right. It can actually cause you a big health hazard. So that's why I decided to do this topic a little bit in detail, explaining you about that hair taming treatment or the straightening treatment, you know, which is widely been done, and we see that every, you know, third woman among us is having a straight hair. We all love to have straight hair, we all love to have shiny and smooth hair, and who doesn't love to, you know, flaunt their beautiful hairs around whenever they walk. There are very few people that they tend to go into the natural look of the hair, like they keep the curly hair or they keep the wavy hair, or, you know, they tend to do a lot of styling with their hair. So what is this hair taming treatment? So under this taming treatment, there are so many names classified, which is keratin, rebonding, Botox, protein, cellophane, smoothening, I don't know what all, you know, names it has been classified, but these all come under one category of called as taming treatment, where it tames your hair, it removes the frizz and it makes your life much easier. Now when you do these kind of treatments, actually they have again further classified. If you have done a treatment or if you have seen someone doing this treatment, you know that when you do this treatment, generally it actually gives a lot of smoke and there is a lot of bad smell, and, you know, your eyes keep watering, and after the treatment it is not guaranteed that your hair will look the same. It might rip off your hair, it might start taking off hair from the scalp, or it can also end up breaking down your hair. So you have to be careful when you do these kind of treatments. First and most important thing, the chemical found in this particular treatment is called formaldehyde. So formaldehyde is actually a gas which you generally find, like when you do some kind of carpentry job or you do some carpeting job at your home, you find those gas coming out, and especially when you do this furniture job, people ask you to, you know, stay out of your home for a certain time. So that's the same gas they use it in these kind of treatment. Remember, when you do these kind of hair home makeovers, if people are asking you to stay out, that same kind of chemical being used in your hair, what will be the situation of your hair? So that's one thing that it is alarmed and it is actually banned. So any product with formaldehyde is banned under UDN with the USA cosmetic the council that they are going through. They say that this chemical is not allowed because it has caused. It is one of the reasons for causing cancer. It also causes miscarriages. It has caused blood hypertension. It has caused many other health hazards to people who have undergone this treatment. Especially, it is very dangerous for the hairstylist or the stylist or the person who does this treatment on a regular basis. And we have seen very sadly that they have to compromise their life when they do these kind of treatment. So please ensure that when you go to a place, the treatment that you're taking, ask them if it is free from formaldehyde. One, second, it even if it is safe for pregnant ladies. So if the treatment is safe for pregnant ladies, that means they have no chemicals, no smoke. Even during the process, if you find there is a smoke coming and your eyes are burning and there is a bad smell coming, the odor is coming, that's because of formaldehyde and other chemicals added to do this keratin or the rebonding or whatever. Basically, rebonding is a big no because I will not recommend it 100% comes with these chemicals. It makes your hair super straight, 100% straight, which is not done usually in an organic taming treatments. Second thing, there is keratin on our hair. So what happens is that when you do these kind of treatments, it binds in the keratin in your hair and it makes it stronger. That's what the purpose of the treatment is. But not doing that, it actually breaks down the bonds, the keratin bonds in your hair, and it damages your hair, causing health hazard to yourself. So as per UAE law, it is completely banned that there is no usage of formaldehyde being used in any of the products, but still there are some places that they use it. So ensure that to save few money or few penny that you go compromise yourself doing these kind of treatments, end up having no hair or causing health hazard to yourself and as well as the stylist. Now, how you will differentiate between organic treatments and the normal treatments? So if you're doing the organic treatment, like we do it over here, we do it for pregnant ladies, we do it for breastfeeding moms, for kids, for teenagers. Absolute no smoke, no eye burning, no any sensation with eyes, no smell, nothing. So during the treatment, the hair is not compromised. If you have a hair fall, the Botox actually generally lowers down that hair fall concerns as well. Also, even if you have very curly and very frizzy hair, it actually removes all your frizz and makes your hair much, much easier to manage. Now, when you do these kind of treatments, it also depends on your hair structure and hair fiber that you tend to go and do that. You can't force your stylist or a salon and spa to do a certain treatment because they check your hair and they are the right person to suggest you these kind of organic treatments, I would suggest, if you want to do it. So there is no problem in doing a taming treatment, but please avoid using doing treatments which has these kind of chemicals. Do not compromise your health or your stylist health or as well as your hair. So this is about the things that you need to take care when you do any kind of taming treatments. Now the aftercare. Usually when you do these kind of organic Botox or organic protein treatment or any kind of treatment that makes your hair straight, they last you for about like 4 to 5 months or maximum 6 months, but for some hair it even lasts more. So we can't tell that whether it will last you even for a year or what, but generally the guarantee given from the brand is like from 4 to 5 months. Now the most important thing is the aftercare products. The aftercare suggested by a salon and spa or anywhere that you do the treatment, and you have to take the aftercare, which is a shampoo and the conditioner from the respective brand, because they are free from sulfate, they are free from parabens, preservative, plus it also have the ingredients of the treatment that you have done which puts back to your hair. After Botox and organic treatment or organic protein or the Botox treatment, avoid going to beaches, avoid going to pools, avoid going for sauna, steam, these kind of things. It's not recommended. The treatment has to stay in your hair and it has to lock in. Also, oiling is not recommended, at least for a month or two, till the hair settles in with the treatment, and then you can start doing your general processes of oiling or whatever. I hope this episode has helped you with a lot of queries that you guys have asked in about the taming treatment. So go and give it a try and make your life easier with a nice smooth hair but without chemicals, and do not compromise your health, your stylist health, and save the community. So that's what we wanted to spread the message. If you have any further questions and you wanted to see that how we do it, what are the different kind of taming treatments we have, please feel free to contact the numbers given below, or you can follow us on Instagram on Facebook page, and do not forget to click the bell notification button for any further notifications of videos that we upload. Hope you liked the episode today. I'll see you next time with a new episode. God bless.